Hello guys and welcome to a new review here at China Mobile Mac. I am Christopher and I am about to tell you everything that you need to know about the Xiaomi Mi Max 3. The Mi Max 3 with a screen size of 6.9 inches is Xiaomi's largest tablet device to date and at international resellers is priced at around 250 euros. So let's dive in. For this review, I decided to purchase the phone at tradingshenzhen.com with 64GB of storage in black. Actually, these guys were the first who had the phone in stock, so if you need a link, it's down below in the info box. At the very first look, the Mi Max 3 looks just like a larger Redmi Note 5. The design is really similar, but there are some differences though. The Mi Max 3 is made from metal entirely and has kind of a pointed shape towards the left and right, which makes it look slimmer than it already is at just 7.9 mm. Sturdiness isn't affected by slimness here, and the Mi Max 3 effortlessly went through the band test without showing any significant amount of flex. But one thing is for sure, the Mi Max 3 ain't good for small hands. I do have large hands, yet one-handed operation is a big no-no on this phone. But given the size, the Mi Max 3 is surprisingly light at just 221 grams. And just to point that out, the Max 3 actually didn't grow that much larger compared to the Max 2 thanks to minimized bezels. The exact dimensions are 176.15 by 87.4 mm. The screen now comes in the 18x9 format and operates at a resolution of 2160 by 1080 pixels. Despite the size, you won't notice any pixels during normal use. The picture quality is totally satisfying, the panel doesn't have the best black levels, but hey, this is just a budget phone, so I am fine with that. Something that's a big plus is the maximum brightness of 520 nits, which makes it a lot more easy to use the phone under bright sunlight. The touchscreen is based on a 10-point unit and works well without much of an input delay. There is just one thing I noticed, and that's an increased amount of typos when typing extremely fast. To me that looks like some kind of software problem though, since it disappears when typing a bit slower. The screen glass has remained scratch-free so far, but Xiaomi doesn't tell what kind of glass they use. The glass isn't a dirt magnet and pretty easy to clean by swiping it over your clothes just once. In addition, the glass also has a nice slip to it. Compared to the Mi Max 2, the Mi Max 3 is a lot faster, which you will definitely notice right away. This is due to the Snapdragon 636 they use on this phone, which is a downclocked Snapdragon 660. The phone scores an Antutu score of about 119,000 points, so you can expect a very decent performance there. All apps will run smooth and without huge loading times. Even gaming is handled fairly well. Most titles can be played at highest graphics settings with a smooth frame rate. Just the most recent titles might show some skipped frames, which can be eliminated entirely by reducing the graphics settings a bit. If you do that, for example on PUBG or World of Tanks, you will get a very smooth gameplay. Thanks to the large screen, such games are easy to control and just a pleasure to play. The heat isn't an issue even when gaming. The back of the phone does get warm, but it's just very slight and not a big deal. There is also no massive thermal throttling. When using MIUI with gesture control, you might notice some slight stutter in the animations. This might be caused by the RAM, which isn't the fastest, reaching a throughput of only 6.65 GB per second. But aside from that, this doesn't have any negative consequences. Multitasking is a breeze, and if you think that 4GB aren't enough for you, there is a 6GB RAM option ready for you to pick. In my opinion, 4GB are plenty enough for most users though. Your personal data and apps find space inside a 64GB or 128GB eMMC 5.1 storage, which reaches a decent throughput. In addition, you can use a microSD card, but that means losing the dual SIM support. Also, bear in mind that MIUI does not support moving apps to the SD card without any additional tools and root access. On the sensors side, Xiaomi fills the Mi Max 3 with more stuff than most people need. Compass and gyroscope are there and work just fine, with the compass needing a calibration before being used first time. The fingerprint scanner on the rear is speedy AF and extremely reliable. But what the heck, why is that thing almost at the phone's top? Really, I have large hands but constantly have issues reaching that damn sensor when holding the phone in one hand. Luckily, there is Face Unlock, which is the perfect way around the misplaced fingerprint scanner. It's fast, reliable at daylight, and can't be tricked with a simple photo. Also, it works surprisingly good in low light. Just at night it will fail, since Xiaomi doesn't use the screen to light up your face during the unlocking process. The Mi Max 3 of course packs a notification light, but this one can only light up in white. The USB port uses the Type-C standard, but it's just a USB 2.0 port, OTG is supported. Right now there is no global ROM for the Mi Max 3, so you have to use it with the China ROM or a translated MIUI project like Xiaomi.eu until there is an official global ROM. Yes, I know that some shops sell a global version, but that is just an unofficial shop ROM you should not use, since it might cause issues. As soon as there is an official global ROM for the Mi Max 3, you will find it at en.miui.com. My review unit was shipped with MIUI 9.6 China Stable, which got free updates during my review and right now runs the security patch of July. The Play Store works fine but has to be installed manually using the Google installer. I will link a tutorial down below which is in German, but using Google Translate you should be able to easily follow it. If you want to prepare your phone for flashing a global ROM later on or using the translated Xiaomi.eu firmware, you need to unlock your bootloader. Please visit en.miui.com/unlock and download the unlocking tool to do so. One weakness of the Mi Max 3 software is the missing widevine level 1, which means that you can't play Netflix in HD. Considering the large display, that is a pity since you definitely will notice a difference in video quality. Something that is quite awesome is reception quality. The phablet boasts support for the Band 20 LTE and the signal strength is among the best I have seen to date. Looks like they used the large body for a very large antenna. And that doesn't only apply to the mobile network, but also to Wi-Fi. Right next to the router, the speeds are great and the throughput doesn't go down much when I tested it one floor below it. The Mi Max 3 also packs Bluetooth 5.0 support and again this works like a charm and easily covers a floor. The GPS, surprise, works like a charm too. Reception quality once again is great and so is accuracy. Navigation works perfect and GPS tracking works very accurate even with the phone inside a pocket. Something I was very surprised about is that the Mi Max 3 packs stereo speakers despite Xiaomi not mentioning them. The earpiece is used as the secondary speaker and the overall audio quality is absolutely fine for a mid-range phone. Just don't expect an intense stereo effect since the earpiece is much weaker than the main speaker. One huge plus is that the Mi Max 3 still packs a 3.5mm headphone jack. Telephony quality is really good on both ends and the active noise cancelling works great. It even manages getting rid of wind noise very well. The main camera is the very same setup as on the Redmi Note 5, a 12MP Samsung S5 K2L7 with f1.9 aperture and a 5MP Samsung S5 K5 E8 secondary sensor. Just the front camera is different from the Redmi Note 5 and uses a 8MP Samsung S5 K4H7 sensor with f2.0 aperture. The main camera for the most part does great shots which do look good in terms of colors and offer a surprisingly decent dynamic range. But every now and then there can be pictures that look a bit blurry or lack detail. That however seems to be a software issue for sure since I have not been able to connect that to a specific scenario and reproduce it. Something I have to mention separately is the HDR mode which gives pictures a very dramatic look when used under the right lighting conditions. You should just make sure that you don't use the automatic HDR since this can cause shaky pictures. The bokeh mode does work very well despite the small 5MP secondary sensor. When capturing stuff with complex contours it can be inaccurate but often a second dry will be fine. Even with a comparably low amount of light, you can still use the bokeh effect. Considering it's a mid-range camera, the Mi Max 3 is able to squeeze a lot of light out of scenes and thus takes great low-light shots, well, at least to a certain degree. There is a point on which the camera suddenly says, no, stop, that's not enough light. Starting from this point, the pictures out of a sudden look rather crappy, noisy and blurred. One way around that is using a tripod and manual mode where you can use long exposure of up to 32 seconds. This enables you to take okay looking shots even on scenes with very low light. The LED flash is quite bright and is the most helpful for low and medium distance as well as smaller rooms. It's quite impressive how short the shutter time is when using the flash, which really helps avoiding shaky pictures. The front camera doesn't take perfect, but nonetheless okay looking selfies at daylight. With less light, there is a visible decrease in quality, but shots are still far away from being unusable. The front camera does support the bokeh mode as well, but it's purely software generated. Still, it works fine given proper lighting is there. If you want to record videos, you can do so in 1080p at 60fps or at 4K at 30fps. The video quality is okay, but there are quite a lot of artifacts on faster movement. The autofocus does work insanely fast and accurate without any pumping. Contrary to that, electronic image stabilization doesn't work great at all in 4K mode. There is a lot of movement when recording while walking. The front camera does record in 1080p and 30fps with a decent quality. The audio quality of videos is okay, but it lacks volume, and when you record in environments with an echo, it can happen that the audio isn't synchronized with the video for some reason. However, that doesn't happen often, so it's not a big deal. When it comes to the battery, the runtime unfortunately isn't as good as on the Mi Max 2. The 5500mAh cell delivers a screen on time of around 12 hours, whereas the Mi Max 2 was able to score up to 14 hours. But still, that's plenty of battery juice that will get most of you through 2 days easily. Charging is done via Quick Charge 3.0, and this takes a bit more than 2 hours to charge the phone from 20 to 100%. So, what's the verdict? Well, after using the Mi Max 3 for roughly 2 weeks as a daily driver, I can surely recommend this one to all phablet fans who don't wanna spend a fortune on their phone. The Mi Max 3 does nearly everything right, and considering the pricing along the guaranteed updates for many years, it is a very solid offering. Is it worth switching from a Mi Max 2? Yep, it sure is. You will notice the better performance immediately, and the much better dual camera is a nice bonus. And if you like this phone but are not a fan of big screens, go for the Redmi Note 5. This will save you a couple of bucks and give you a smaller device while essentially being the same phone. And with that being said, we reached the end of this review. I was Christopher, thanks for watching, and I will catch you in the next one. Bye.